This massive 75-inch TV behind me is impressive, not because it's so big, but because it's so small. It's made of micro LEDs, millions of individual pixels, all emitting their own light, and it's the first time Samsung has been able to make them small enough and close enough together to make a TV that would realistically fit in somebody's house. Now, I'm not allowed any closer in case I break it, but they have got one of the panels here underneath the microscope, and it does look very impressive. So why is this supposed to be better than existing TVs on the market? Well, those individual pixels are very bright, and when they're off, they're very dark, so you get very good contrast for those HDR movies. Samsung also says the system is modular. They've got a demonstration here where bits are added to the screen, and then they split apart and then come together again for a super widescreen movie. Because it's modular, you can also replace any of the pixels if they happen to break. You can just remove them and replace them rather than throwing away the whole screen. That's good for people at home, and also good for Samsung in their manufacturing, because they'll save money. And because it's modular, you can go pretty much as big as you like if you've got a big enough house. They've got one here that's more than 200 inches across called the Wall, although that one doesn't use the super compact micro LEDs that we've seen in that 75-inch prototype today. One of your competitors makes a big deal about their organic LEDs, OLED TVs. You're promoting these as inorganic. What's the difference?
It's just the panel structure and the way it's built out. And one of the benefits of it being inorganic is the projected lifetime is longer, and you don't have the fear of burn-in over time. So we feel much more comfortable that this is going to deliver a longer and more robust and more well-rounded viewing experience than the other technology is able to do.
And it's just a prototype at the moment. How far away is something like this in reality?
There's been no set date, and we'll really just see what the market demands. And it may be something that's a year down the road, 2 years down the road. There really hasn't been anything finite delivered as far as a date yet.